friends, today let me actually take an example situation where you want to order a particular flower of quantity n, and you have choices of choosing among 10 flowers or m flowers. Suppose m is 10. So when you just give a type of flower which you want to buy, and if it is an invalid flower, if it is not there among those 10, then what should the program stop there? No. So our program should ask again for the flower name, stating that the entered flower name is invalid. So what are we doing here? So we are checking the user input, and if it is not correct, we are asking again, and if it is not correct again, we are asking it again. So what is this? So we are doing some callback. So I need to discuss callback method, and I am using switch case in this program. So if you see this video, you will be able to understand how to implement a continuous callback requirement in Java, and also how to use switch statement. Apart from that, we are using method calls, and we are using scanner class in this example. So first of all, this is the syntax to take use scanner class to take the input from the user. So we'll be defining a starter scanner object, suppose you say a keyboard, and using this keyboard we will be taking the entered value. Suppose we want here, actually we want to take the flower name. So what we are doing, we are taking the next line. So whatever we are giving in the console, that entire line it is taking, and this index is of type string. So we are just initializing the empty index, and we are actually assigning it here. So at the same time, we want to convert this to lower case, because suppose if the flower name is Lily, you can give capital LI, small LLI. So it is like we are converting it to lowercase to use it in our switch statement. So in whenever you are using this switch statement, so this is very one important thing, that you need to convert the user input to lower letter or upper letter, so that whatever it might be, we just want to see whether the name is exactly same or not. So according to that, once we take that using these lowercase values, we are creating a switch statement. Okay, so we are taking the flower name here, and what we are doing is we are just printing what kind of flowers would you like to purchase. Is it this, or so many? Like we are given 10 names here. So after that, we are initializing the cost of the flower that user want to zero. So this is one of the important step, like in our while it should enter for the first time. So we are checking with the cost equals to zero, since we have initialized it to zero, and we have to implement again all of these things only when the cost new equals to zero. What I mean is, like if we enter an invalid flower name, so we have to repeat the process again. So what we have to do, we have to make sure that whenever we give an invalid name, we set the cost to that case as zero, so that this keeps on going like looping. So what we are doing, so we are taking the flower name, we are converting it to lowercase. So then we are calling a switch statement. So friends, so this is a switch case. So in switch case we will be passing a variable. So here we have converted our flower name into lowercase, and we are using it as a base variable in switch statement. So using this variable, so we are creating different cases. So if our variable name is Petunia, so in that case cost will be 0.50. so if you observe carefully, we are using break. So what happens when we use break is it will skip the execution of the further statements inside this switch, and it will come out of the switch statement. So if the case is pansy, it will enter the pansy, but it will get break and it don't enter into the other case. So in the same way, we make sure that we give default as 0, because if the name doesn't match with any of the case, so we need to give the cost equals to 0, because for the first time we made it enter into the while loop using cost equals to 0 here, and that's what we want to do it again, because we want the process has stopped, like we have given an invalid name. So we want to repeat the process again. It should take it again from the user. We have to convert it again to the lowercase, and we have to see if the cost is 0, then we will print invalid flower name. So because if the switch method is returning 0, we mean that we have given it as a invalid. It doesn't fall in the 10 cases. So if we are printing it as an invalid flower name again, so and again since it is 0, it will enter into the loop again. So if it is not 0, means that the switch statement had got one flower name matching to one among those 10, and so it will stop executing the switch statement, while statement, while loop and it will come to the next line. So it will ask for how many flowers would you like. So then we will be giving the count. So once we give the count, we are doing count dot cost to give the total. So we are printing the total. So now I'll execute it. So Java C, our class name dot Java, this is used for compiling. So once it's compiled, our Java class will be converted to bytestream. So dot class file. So now it's runnable. So now it has become platform independent, so it is executable now. So now our JVM knows how to run this in Windows platform, since we have installed Windows JVM. So Windows JVM know how to execute the executable. So dot class is an executable here. So now we are running the executable file. So it has printed all the possible flowers. It's asking us what kind of flowers would you like to purchase. So now if I give a dummy a wrong value like JU, so what it does, it shows invalid flower name and asks us to give correct name. So if I give a rose, so it will then tell how many roses would you like. Suppose if I say 6, so it shows the cost of 6 roses is 9.0. Okay friends.